Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about Nifty breakout levels. By watching this video you can gain more knowledge about market also. Those who are new to channel, kindly subscribe the channel and select the ring bell. If you feel like the video, kindly select the like button and share it. By selecting the name of this channel, NSC Commodity Trader, you will go to home page. In home page you can see more strategy videos, indicator videos in home page also. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for commodity also. If you want to know about these details, means you can WhatsApp or contact the number which is given the below of the video. If you want to open a DMAT or trading account, kindly select the link in below description. The account opening process will follow. Nifty on Friday opened as a gap down of 12,320 range. After it opened as a gap down, market started to rally to the upside of the level. The upside distance, first one is 12,350. After a breakout has been seen at 12,350, the next level distance is 12,400. But market cannot able to make a breakout in this level, 12,400. Currently, Nifty 12,400 is seen as a major resistance for Nifty. So after reached that level, within half an hour market go in that price. After that market again started to fall and it traded as a flat market. So today market ended up as a downside market only. Let's take a look at stocks also, what happened in stocks today. 52 week new high has been achieved by the Berger Paint and then the IGL. If you take a look at the paints and IGL, means this peak, the paint sector and then the gas sector, they are performed very well. So this week they rallied very well, gas sector and Berger Paints. And then one out of the box, that is Google's parent company Alphabet, that reached $1 trillion market capital. This is the fourth US company that reached this much market capital. And then the another one that affected the market, that is today a news came related adjusted gross revenue, AGR. That is the, they have reapplied for review, AGR review, but the Supreme Court has rejected the review. Due to that rejection, Vodafone Idea has been opened as a gap down and then it falled up to 39%. Today Idea falled up to 39%. And then the bank related to this Idea shares, like telecom companies that related banks also falled very down. That is be like IndusInd Bank falled 2%, because they all invested in these telecom companies. So if they falled, telecom companies has falled, means that will affect the bank related shares also. And many of them will don't know what is the review, what is going on. That the debt is like for Vodafone Idea, it is 53,000 crores they need to pay to the government. And then the Bharti Airtel, they need to pay 35,000 crores they need to pay to the government. And then the Tata Telecom is 13,000 crores. These are the debt they need to pay to the government. This debt is completely related to the spectrum of the 2G related. That is the news. Due to the tower related news, the Vodafone Idea, Airtel, Tata Telecom, they all affected. But Airtel is not going to get major affection. Instead of Airtel, the Infratel share is going to get major affected, because today Infratel, Bharti Infratel also opened as a gap down of 10%. Bharti Airtel is a little bit related to the Infratel. They getting the tower from them. So the major one that is going to affect is Bharti Infratel only, not Bharti Airtel. Due to many of them don't know this, they don't know why Bharti Airtel is rising, because today Bharti Airtel opened as a gap up and then started to move up very well of 493, and today made a record new 52 week high of 503.80. that is the last 1 year high. And Bharti Airtel all time high is 523 only, so it will be soon reachable. Currently Bharti Airtel has very good phase going on upside. And then another one, this is the major one, Jio. If their rival are going to fall, the Vodafone Idea is going to get out of the market, means then it will be a very very good news for Jio. So Jio opened as a gap up of 1553. After it opened a gap up, it started to rally very well. Today it reached up to 3% positiveness in the market. Already the result is going to come. Instead of those also, they have a positive news from this AGR also. Due to these things, Reliance also started rally very well. Let's come back to Nifty. Nifty is currently facing a strong resistance at 12,400 range. So currently it will be like a previous version of 12,300, because whenever market came to 12,300, market started to falling down. Currently the new high, that is the new resistance, new level for Nifty is 12,400. Actually this is a very positive week for Nifty. Let's take a look at weekly candle also, so we can have some idea what happened during this week also. If you take a look at this weekly candle, means it's a gap up. A gap up has been happened. After that gap up of 12,300, market rallied up to 12,400. It is a very, very low volatile, very 100 points, only 100 point movement, up to 120 point movement only happened in this week. Very low volatile, low movement this week. But whenever market in a peak position or high position, the market will be very less volatile, because whenever market rise, it will rise very slowly only, step by step only it will move up. But whenever market fall, it will move very fast, it will move very fast, very pull down very fast also. So during this uprise, market moved very well, step by step they improved. If you take a look at day candle, means you can have some idea, because on Monday a new high has been made by the Nifty, and then again a new high has been made, and then again a new high, like range will be like 340 and then the 370 and then the 389. So currently 12,389 is seen as the highest value for Nifty. So according to the situation, this week is 3 new high has been made by the Nifty. So currently a strong resistance is 12,400. So if market break above 12,400, that means at least it need to start to move above 12,389. If it happened, means you can expect some positiveness in the market, like market can able to move another 40 point rally in the upside. So if you see any breakout of 12,389 range, means you can buy Nifty or Nifty stocks that is rallying at that time, and then expect another or 5.5%, like 40 points, 50 points you can expect in the upside also. So this will be the current resistance level for Nifty on Monday. And then the supportive range, first level is 12,350. If market opened above 12,350, means the first level support is 12,350, and then the next one major support, because this week whenever market touches 12,300, market pushed back. So 12,300 is seen as the major supportive level for Nifty. Major resistance is 12,400, major support is 12,300. So these are the support and resistance level, that is major one for Nifty. And then the flip over is 12,350. If market opened below 12,350 and it crosses 12,350, means you can expect another 40 points during this rally up to 389. Okay, so if it crosses 350 range, means you can buy and expect some 40 points, 30 point, 35 points in the upside on the market also. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for crude oil, copper, zinc and gold. If you want to know about these details, means you can WhatsApp or contact my number. We are also referring, and if you want to open a DMAT or trading account, means you can select the link in below description or contact my number. In future, if you want to see more videos like this, means kindly subscribe my channel and select the ring bell. Thank you.